Hi everyone and welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Now, don't forget to subscribe and follow us to stay up to date. Today we have a provisional bridge broken down. Now you can see the breakage point and we want to analyze why it broke down. We changed the prosthetics parts and we fixed the issue of why it broke down in the first place. That's what we're going to be covering today, and we'll also be able to take a look at how we analyze what we did in the process of changing the parts. First of all, we had the upper bridge. You can see that you have a 4 millimeter sleeve. Then you had the screw channel, but then it broke down in the place of the sleeve. So we saw that the surface of the cut around the sleeve is too small because you have quite a large span between the different implants. So we changed the sleeve to a smaller one and we eliminated the screw channels. So the surface cut is much bigger and it can withstand much more forces. We don't have a screw channel at all. It actually doesn't hold on the sleeve. It just sits on the multi-unit. The vertical forces that you have, they all go straight to the multi-unit. The bridge will be stable. You have enough material to hold it, and because we eliminated the screw channel and made a smaller sleeve, we managed to remove all of the material from the upper part of the bridge. And this part of the bridge is not in a deep bite, so the patient doesn't close right on the bridge. It has much less forces that go on top of the bridge. The vertical forces are smaller and the vertical forces go right to the multi-unit, right on the implant. So it holds this part of the bridge. Now in cemented restoration, you would have a whole different problem because first of all, for cemented restoration, you need enough surface, enough height for the abutment. You can't switch for a 1.5 millimeter abutment. There is no such thing. It won't hold at all because it's all on cement. You have the preparation angle. The preparation angle is about 5 to 10 degrees. You can't just make a 1.5 millimeter abutment and cement the bridge on top of this abutment. It won't hold at all. You would need to have some height. Now, in this case, if you have this height, you need to have more material that goes right on top of the abutment. It doesn't change anything, and you don't want to make the finish line above the gingival line because all of the residue of the cement will go below the gingival level. It's very hard to clean them up. Now, in the cemented version, it is much harder to make. Zirconium material is a very rigid material. You don't have any movement in the bridge itself. The only movement that you can have is on the vertical forces when you bite on top of the anterior teeth. When you bite on the anterior teeth, this part of the bridge wants to go down. When it goes down, the sleeve sits on top of the multi-unit and it holds the forces of the bridge. We eventually saw in this case that when we switched from a 3 millimeter sleeve to a 1.5 and without the screw, it didn't break with the provisional bridge. We made a zirconium bridge and it didn't break down also. And it holds for 1.5 years, at least in the mouth, withstanding all of the pressure and all of the forces that go on top of these implants and these sleeves. Up next, you can see the types of sleeves that we have for these types of multi-units. We have different types of sleeves and each type of sleeve has its own function. For example, the 4 millimeter sleeve is the standard type of sleeve that we use in most cases, like 95% of the cases. It has enough height for the cementation and it's small enough so you can make a crown on top of it. The 3 millimeter is a bit shorter so you can make a crown and have a little less cementation. It still will hold, but because it's quite small, you can't make the screw float inside the sleeve like we're doing in the 4 millimeter sleeves. Now, the 1.5 millimeter sleeve is for the most extreme cases. First of all, you can screw it, but all of the screw will be in the restoration material in the zirconia or in the metal of the PFM bridge. The screw won't be in the sleeve at all, and you have very minimal surface for the cementation. So the cementation must be perfect. You need to have a macro and micro retention. You need to use the strongest cement possible, and the 6 millimeter sleeves are for when you have very high crowns and want the momentum of the crown to not break the cement. So you use very high sleeves. You almost never use them in the middle, but still it's possible to use them. So why produce it? You're probably wondering why we produce it and why we don't just take the 3 millimeters and cut it. It is possible to take even a 6 millimeter and cut it into 1.5. The base of the sleeve is the exact same, but if you go back and check this slide, you can see that in this case, we had a library where in the library, we had 3 millimeters. We have the 4 and 6 and 1.5, all of these types of sleeves. So if you made a bridge with, for example, a 4 millimeter sleeve and you want to change it to a 1.5, you can just with 2 clicks and a little bit of adjustments, you can change it. You don't need to do everything from the beginning. If you want to do the same with a sleeve cutting, first of all, you need to scan the sleeve. If you scan the sleeve, you need to make all of the work from the start. There is a possibility to make cutting steps. For example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 to be able to cut the sleeve according to the line that you want, but then you have problems fitting the sleeve. You will cut more than you need and you'll have space between the crown and the sleeve itself. So this way the sleeve fits best and you don't need to do any excessive work to change from two types of sleeves. You can just change from one library to the other with two clicks and just adjust it a little bit. The bridge, you can see we took down a little bit of material from here and made it smooth. All the work is the same and it's very easy to change from one sleeve to another. You don't need to start from the beginning. Making everything from the start for these types of cases can take 1 to 3 hours. So the 1.5 millimeters is the smallest, but it will hold because we're not just cementing the sleeve to the bridge. We're making micro and macro retention. You'll see two slides below. First of all, you can see here the bridge itself. You can see that in the bridge, you don't have a screw channel. You have a very small area for the cementation, and you can see you have like an undercuts inside the bridge. We just take a burr. If it's a PMMA material, you'll mill in the PMMA. If it's zichronia, you can make these undercuts before the centering process. You just take a burr with your hand and just make some small micro retention. Now, to produce it in the CNC machine, in the CAD-CAM process is very, very difficult. Not every machine can do it, and you need different strategies. From our experience, the best thing is just in 5 minutes, do it yourself. You take a small burr, you do some micro retentions, you don't have any problems in the milling part of the bridge because everything else goes like standard. The end result of this micro retention is as you can see here. It's like small undercuts for the sleeves. We do it for all the sleeves, not just 1.5 millimeters. We do it for the 3, 4, and 6. You have much better retention for these ones. Then when you cement the sleeve, the cement or the glue depends on what you use, goes into these undercuts and holds the sleeve. In the sleeve, you have undercards that cement holds with undercuts. And in here, you have different types of undercuts. So the cement can hold the sleeve much better. We recommend doing undercuts in every screw retained restoration when you're cementing the sleeve. In cementing restoration, it's the worst thing you can do doing undercuts because when you're doing cemented restoration, you have a bridge. You cement the bridge on temporary cement because the angulation of the preparation is almost parallel. It's very hard to take off the crown. So if you make undercuts in the bridge, it will be almost impossible to remove the crowns from the abutments. And one of the biggest problems in cemented restoration is when you need to remove the crowns. You need to break the cement, and if the cement has bigger undercuts, the cement holds much better the crowns. It's almost impossible to break and release the crowns without breaking them. There's almost no such thing as permanent cemented restoration because you're almost always afraid when you use cemented restoration, the point when you need to remove the cemented restoration. On the teeth, yeah, you use permanent cement because there's no screw loosening. There isn't any issue with that. There's almost no reason that you don't need to take off the bridge, but when you use it on implants, you have a problem because there can be a screw loosening. There can be a lot of different issues. When you have a chance for different problems, you have like a 5% in 3 years in all of the implants that you have screw loosening. It's a lot. So you want to be able to remove the crowns. Thank you everyone that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you and see you next time.